Oh shit, what to do? I know. Yeah. What's up, guys? Welcome to the Hardwin 82 channel. I'm Adam, and today we're gonna talk a little bit about the electricity, the power, how much computer these days is using power, and especially how many devices you can connect to your power wall socket or to the extension lead like this. If you wanna know something about that, stay tuned. Have you ever wondered how many devices you can connect to something like that? Obviously, this extension lead has a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 socket, so in theory I can connect 6 devices, but is there any limitation? And if there is, what is it? How to check it? How to know what kind of devices I can connect to this? For example, you just bought your brand new computer, and you have all those cables. You have a cable from PSU, from your monitor, from your printer, maybe from steering wheel like this, and other things like maybe you want to charge a phone, maybe you want to use some kind of lighting. How many things you can connect to extension lead like this? Because you need to remember, all those devices will go only to your single wall socket. So how to find out? Let's talk about that. Guys, this subject, like every other probably, could be very difficult, but I will try to make this as simple as possible and short as possible. There is this one rule you need to follow. Amps multiply volts equals watts. So depends where you live, and this part is very, very important because every country is different. For example, I'm living in UK now, and wall sockets are using here in England 13 amps and 230 volts. So what that means exactly? So I'm multiplying 13 amps with 230 volts and I have 2990 watts. That means that I can connect to the power socket in the wall one device up to almost 3000 watts. So these days a lot of devices can draw that kind of power. So for example, hair dryer, microwave, toaster, only this one device can take up to 3000 watts. So you need to be careful. You cannot use something like this and pair, for example, toaster and microwave to the same lead extension, because if you try to use them in the same time, you will have a problem. Another example, Australia is using 10 amps. So in this case, 10 multiply 230 and we have 2300 watts. So for you, doesn't matter where you're from, I will now place information about electricity in your country. So have a look at that and make this quick calculation to know where we stand right now. Okay, so you just bought your brand new computer, you have your computer, monitor, everything. How to know how many things I can connect to this? So already we know what is the maximum amount of watts we can use. So in my case, it's almost 3000 watts. So from now on, what you need to do, if we are talking about the computer, to the computer, remember, there is only one cable that goes to your PSU power supply. So have a look at your power supply, just the label on the side, and have a look what is the maximum amount, like probably 500 watts, 600, 800, maybe a little bit more. That means that your computer can draw maximum up to that amount. Doesn't mean it takes all the time that amount, but it is just prepared that can handle up to that number. So in my case, I have 750 watts. So one power cable goes to one empty slot here. So I have already 750. This is just in theory. Then I have a monitor that can take up to 50-60 watts. So I need to add that. Then I have some lighting. This, for example, can take up to 25 watts. So I'm adding this. So your job now is just to have a look what you are connecting to your Power Elite extension, and just make sure that you are covered. All right, guys, I could end this video right here, right now, because already you know what to do. But there are a few rules you need to follow, which I'm gonna talk right now. Rule number one: you already know that you cannot exceed the maximum amount of watt per wall power socket, but try to never reach the maximum amount. So for example, if in my case I want to use all those empty slots and I'm close to 2990 watts, that's not a good idea. In this case I will disconnect something, I will connect to another power wall socket, and this will be much safer. So this is the rule number one: never go too close to the maximum amount you can use. Rule number two: always buy lead extension with so-called surge protection. I will explain this a little bit later. So don't be cheap, trust me, don't be cheap, because one problem will fry all the devices connected to your power lead. So surge protection, always be protected. Number three: always be very cautious with small devices in your house, like kettles, like ions, toasters. This one device can take up to 3000 watts, so be very careful with that and never pair them together. Number four: never do, it's called daisy chain. It means that you connect one lead extension to another one, and maybe even another one. Never do that. Number five: be very careful with using twin outlet sockets. General rule is, don't connect two devices, even if they are using different slots in your house, because at the end of the day you're not sure how this power outlet socket is connected. So general rule, just to be safe, don't connect two very power hungry devices to twin outlet sockets. Another tip: if you are not sure how much power your devices are taking, you can use online socket calculator. It's very simple. Just from the list you are picking devices you want to use, and just drag and drop, and you will know exactly how much power they draw. Tip number seven: never cover your lead extensions, like for example under the carpet or behind something, like this small gap. The reason is simple: the current that goes through the wiring generates heat, and you don't want to have fire in your house. Thing number eight: never buy those cheap adapters that we are using these days to charge our phones. They are extremely dangerous. The way how they were made is really bad. So like I said before, the electricity that goes through the wiring generates heat, and those cheap adapters, they can't handle this. They are simply failing and causing a fire in your house. Finally, guys, what is the best lead extension? The best lead extension is a lead extension with a surge protection. Surge protection sends unwanted electricity to the grounding wire. This excess voltage is sent back to the return line in your building. This might trip your circuit breaker, but will not damage your devices. So we are looking for lead extensions with a surge protection, and sometimes you will notice also information about the joules. Some of those devices has like 600 joules, 800 joules, 900 joules. What that means? That means basically how much energy those devices can collect. So for example, if you have a thunderstorm and there is this lightning very close to your house, and this excess of electricity goes to your house. More joules means they can handle more. And probably the last thing, simply, if you're not sure what device to buy, just go on the internet, go to your uncle google.com and just type the best lead extension 2021. Simple. All right, guys, that's gonna be it. I hope the video was useful for you. If it was, consider subscribing, and don't forget to smash that like button, and I will see you next time. Thank you. See ya.